Salesforce.com. So the definition of this is in the last line. So if you haven't read the last line, I think you probably will not be able to answer. It is a suite of CRM products which combine together in order to make the organization work efficiently. And in an organization, there are different like different departments, different roles, different responsibilities, different things that needs to be done. Like we need to sell, we need to market, we need to analyze, we need to do customer support, we need to do customer service, we need to run operations, we need to do finance, we need to do accounting, everything. So this platform is capable of doing it all, which is required by a business. And that's only the beginning. You can customize it according to your needs and requirements. And that's again, one step only. The another step is you can create a complete new application from scratch, because Salesforce is not only a suite of CRM products, but it's a platform as well, on top of which you can create a create custom applications according to the needs and requirements of your business. That's what it is. Got it? Everyone? You sure? You want me to repeat it? Yes? I guess you want to. Salesforce.com is a suite of CRM products. What I mean by that there are different products that are there in Salesforce.com, which help a company do different jobs. Like if they want to sell, they've got a different application. If they want to market, the market is basically marketing. Do the advertising and do the marketing thing and get capturing the leads and everything. They've got a different application. If they want to analyze, they've got a different tool or application. So for every function of a business or for every aspect of a business, they've got an application, and that application can be customized. These are like the applications which we have got as a part of Salesforce.com are called as standard application or standard products. And these standard applications and standard products can be customized according to the needs and requirements of your business. Not only that, you can create applications on top of it completely from scratch, which do not have any relation to any other business, but that's respective to your, that's only for your business. You want to create it. That also you can do that, because Salesforce provides you that capability to develop that application on top of it with the help of point and click tools as well as code. So that's what Salesforce is, as I'll sum it up. That's the next topic that you have to read. And then I'm going to ask you the question. What is CRM? You got what is Salesforce.com? Good. Let's go to CRM. Read it. Well, I'll see the chart. Keep a track of, yeah, exactly. This is what it is. Read it. None? No one? Tell me. Process? CRM. Agile is a process or methodology. this is not a process. Where is it written? You're repeating the definition. Explain it to me in a like. Okay, tell me. It is a process and methodology and... Only to gather the customer requirements? Let me tell you what it is. Instead of me asking you guys, let me explain it to you on the very first point. You all are using a mobile phone. You all have our Tata Sky or Dish TV or whatever you want to call it, like installed at our home. We all have got that. The information about the plan that we are using on our mobile phone, the calls that we are making to another people, how long the duration was, how much data we are consuming and everything is getting stored into one particular system. And that system is of is owned by this by the mobile network that we are using. If we are using Airtel, it's stored with Airtel. If we are using AT&T, it's stored with AT&T. If we are storing it with Verizon, it's stored with Verizon. So they have got a system where all of the information, literally all of the information about their customer is stored onto a system. And the interaction that they're having with the executives over there. So whenever we call the support, whenever we call the call center, the problem that we faced is getting tracked over there. The resolution or the solution that we got for that problem is tracked over there. The messages that we get is also tracked over there. Everything is managed by a single system. And that's not only storing the information about customers only, it's storing the information about our employees, our products, our services, our everything is stored onto one system, which can be accessed from anywhere around the world in order to serve our customer better. That's what a CRM is. So when you've got all the information about your customer, like, okay, so if this is the guy and this guy is into this particular college and this guy called us four times and in this call, this is what he discussed, If we know all of it, like whether it will be easier for us to sell him the course or sell him the training program, because we already know what all conversation we have had with him and now the call that we want to make, what we need to talk about. Anyway, earlier he was facing a problem, like I didn't got the notes in the night and I didn't got the notes, please share it with me. So he raised this query. So if the person who is responsible to respond him is not responding to him, then like how are we going to manage that he's getting the service that he should deserve or he should get with the help of this system? And CRM is a single system which manages the relationship with your customer and how it manages that by storing all of the information, all of the small pieces of information together at one place, and which helps your executives, which helps your support executives, support staff, not only support executives, support staff, but sales staff, marketing people, and everyone else in your organization serve better to your customer. And it's all about customers today in today's time. We're not going to that departmental store anymore because we've got Amazon, which gives great customer support. Even if you've bought anything which costs 50,000 or even a lakh, we can return it by just a click. That'll not happen if we go to that store or that department store or whatever you want to call it. Getting it? It's about customer service in today's time. And every business, every organization wants to give better customer service. And there is no chance that each and every employee or every executive is going to be dedicated enough to give that service or to provide that better customer service. So for that, we need a system, and that system is called as a CRM. Is it clear? You got it? Got it? No, didn't got it. Okay. Do I need to talk in Hindi? Are you comfortable? You're comfortable with English, right? Please don't you're comfortable with it, right? Okay. Let me give you a situation. So you're using a mobile phone. Which mobile network are you using? Like Vodafone. So how long you have been using Vodafone? 2 years. Earlier than that, were you using any mobile phone or you were using any different Airtel? So why you moved from Airtel to Vodafone? Network issue. So there was a problem, right? And because of that, you moved to someone else. So don't you think that many of the similar people like you were facing this problem? They were facing this problem. And they must have moved to another mobile operator. They have. How would Bharti Airtel got to know about this? Do you have a personal contact with them? No. So how would they got to know about it? Or how will they get to know that how many people are facing the mobile network issues? And because of that, they're moving to someone else. There must be lakhs of people, right? And lakhs of people means like crores of revenue. So how to solve that issue? Bharti Airtel is dedicated enough, but the other people who are working at Airtel are not dedicated enough to solve your problem. They're like, if you want to use it, else go somewhere else. Why would I care? I'm getting my salary. So how would the leaders of the organization, how would the people who are working at the top will get the information about how the customer's experience is with the help of a system which stores the information of the people or of the customers, that what interactions are happening with them, what plans they are on, what billing cycles that they're doing, what revenues they are generating. So when the business grows large, or even if in today's time, small business also needs insights about the business. The people, the key people of the business wants to get the insights of the business. And people can lie to us, but the system and the data cannot lie to us. So that's where we need the system that will store the data, which will not lie to us. And that system is CRM. So your information must be stored over there, that this guy, that system is CRM. That system is CRM. That system. Your information is just a record or a data. That system is CRM. So Salesforce is a CRM. So in Salesforce, your information is stored. And CRM is nothing but a software. That's it. Got it? Any other question you want? Got it, everyone? Good. Now let's talk about Salesforce architecture, right? I think there's a question on the chat. Maintaining the good relationship with customer. Exactly. Salesforce architecture. Okay. So Salesforce has got different clouds. Sales cloud for sales, service cloud for service, marketing cloud for marketing, and a lot of others. So let's have a look at different products that Salesforce has got. Number one, Chatter. So Chatter is nothing but Facebook for Salesforce, which helps like individuals or the executives or the partners or the users interact with each other. They can share a post with each other. They can send a personal direct message. They can follow each other and do all that stuff, which we do on a social media platform. You have got your own social media platform for your work, which is called as Chatter now, if you and your company is using Salesforce. Got it? Everyone? Then comes Sales Cloud. So Sales Cloud is, again, the pre-built application that you get as a part of Salesforce, which helps you and your sales staff close deals and do the sales. And whatever you develop, which is a part of sales or which helps the salespeople, is also a part of Sales Cloud. Got it? Got it? Okay. Let me give you another example. This is Android. Android is owned by Google. But you need to install or download and install Google Music in order to play music. So that's a product of Google, which is again running on a product of Google. Getting it? So Salesforce is a platform which has got different products. Sales Cloud is the core. Is the core of Salesforce. It's the first product that Salesforce developed, which was only dedicated or which was only targeting the salespeople working in an organization to do the sales effectively. That's what it is. Got it? Sure? Okay. Next, Service Cloud. Service Cloud helps the customer support or the customer service people. Any guesses? Yeah. Like, these are good. Service Cloud helps like the customer support agents or the support staff or support executives do the support or provide the customer service, provide a better customer service. That's what it is. Next is App Exchange. I think we discussed what is App Exchange. What is it? Marketplace. It's a marketplace for Salesforce applications. So that's what it is. Next is data.com. Data.com is, have you heard, I think you guys know about the Yellow Pages. Have you ever heard about Yellow Pages? What it is? No? From which generation are you? Yellow Pages was that yellow diary that used to come into our houses, on which there was contact numbers for each and everyone around the city, around the state, whatever, which kind of Yellow Page that you had. So it's similar with data.com. Data.com is basically used to get the CRM records, to get the information about different people who are working into different organizations. That's what it is. It's again a product. You're not going to use anything amongst these later, but I'm just giving you a gist, an introduction. This is not what you're going to work on, by the way. This is not what it's going to be like for the rest of the time. This is an introduction. It might be a little boring. I can understand that. But the thing is, the information of these things is really important. You need to at least get a 360 view of Salesforce before actually getting into Salesforce, so that you know what is around it. Again, then is Heroku. Force.com is what? Platform? Or platform, someone said as a service. Who said it? Okay. So Force.com is a platform as a service. It's a PaaS, which is used to develop applications on top of Salesforce. So with the help of Force.com, we develop applications on top of Salesforce with the help of Apex, Visual Force, and Lightning. These are the languages which are supported by Force.com. But what if I do not know Apex, I do not know Visual Force, I do not know Lightning, and I've created an application in Java and I want to run it on Salesforce? What if I've created an application on Ruby and I want to run it on Salesforce? No, it's not that easy to convert the code in Apex, right? And they're not converters for Apex. It's not that highly popular right now. And there are you can find the converters for open source languages. Apex is not open source. So what to do? So even if you have developed an application in any other programming language, you can deploy it on Salesforce with the help of Heroku. It's also a PaaS product. So whenever you want to develop an application, if you want to develop it in Apex Visual Force, you're going to use Force.com. If you want to develop it in on any other language, any open source language like Java, Ruby, or PHP, or Go, something like that, then in that case, you can develop it with the help of Heroku. Is it clear? Okay. Then comes next. Third. Yellow pages. Ads. Oh, yeah. Similar to Just Dial. Yeah, similar to Just Dial. Just Dial is different. Just Dial will give you leads and everything. Data.com is a little different. Yeah, I mean, you can say it's similar to Just Dial. Then comes Radian 6. So now Radian 6 is not anymore valid. There is Einstein that's there. Salesforce Einstein. It's the analytics cloud of Salesforce. So it's the AI. Not done the analytics cloud. There is Wave Analytics for analytics cloud. But there is Einstein. So like, have you ever heard about Watson? You know about Alexa, Google, Siri. So these are the AI platforms of, like, Siri is for Apple. For Google, it's Google only. For Amazon, it's Alexa. For Salesforce, it's Einstein. Getting it? AI, artificial intelligence. Then comes site.com. Everyone knows about WordPress. What it is? WordPress. Okay, so you're right. It's a platform to build applications, to build web applications with the help of drag and drop tools. So that gets developed on WordPress platform. If you want to create web portals or web applications on top of Salesforce without writing the code, just by a drag and drop, you can use site.com. So over here in this diagram, have a look. There's a layer. This is a PaaS layer. In this layer, Force.com we use when we want to develop applications on top of Salesforce using Apex Visual Force. Heroku we use when we want to develop applications on top of Salesforce using any other open source programming languages. Site.com we use whenever we want to develop web applications or web portals or some social media channels or something like that on top of Salesforce with the help of drag and drop tools. Then we use Site.com. That's what it is. Make sense? Next is database.com. So it's a database engine for cloud application developers. That's what it is. You got it? Let's have a look at the architecture. And by the way, Salesforce architecture is not publicly released because it's a for-profit company. So like they haven't shared it, but this is exactly what we see it as. So, sites, portals, communities, native HTML5. So these are the interfaces with the help of which we interact or communicate with Salesforce. Then there is Chatter. Chatter is used for social collaboration and everything. Then there is Sales Cloud pre-built application, Service Cloud pre-built application. Custom apps is what? The application that we create, right? Then there is App Exchange, Marketplace. Then there is data.com, again, yellow pages, stuff like that. Force.com to create applications, Apex Visual Force to create applications, open source languages, or onto external applications into Salesforce. Site.com, web portals or something like that, drag and drop. And then there is database.com, and then there is trusted multi-tenant infrastructure. That's what it is. And then there is APIs integration. If you want to integrate it with a mobile application, oops, you can do that with this layer. Let's go. Then let's talk about benefits of Salesforce. Okay. Number one benefit of Salesforce is highly customizable. We have heard it a lot of times, and it is the fact that Salesforce is very, very highly customizable. And that's the reason it's growing at a rapid pace. Number two, it is one which comes with three major releases, adapting to the user's requirement, which is increasing the user adoptability rate. Okay. So Salesforce updates itself and its products every 4 months. Every 4 months, such a giant like Salesforce updates its application. Getting it? And how it updates is, there's an idea portal, like we all are users. We think that this functionality should also be there in Salesforce. This functionality should also be there in Salesforce. This functionality should also be there in Salesforce. So I can create or raise an idea that this is the idea, this functionality should be there. And then if there are other people who think that there should be a similar, there should be an idea like this, there should be a functionality like this, they're gonna upvote it. And the more the upvotes are, the more chances of the product team of Salesforce seeing that idea and implementing it into the next releases. Getting it? So with the help of this idea portal and everything, the users who are there are staying onto that platform because whatever they can customize, they are doing it. And whatever functionality they want from Salesforce, they're getting it with the help of this idea thing. And new users are also joining. So this thing, this release thing, release is like, give me a second. Winter, like winter 19 was there first. Then they're going to be spring 19. Then there will be summer 19. And after summer 19, there will be winter 20. And then there's going to be summer spring 19. And then there's going to be, spring 20. And then there's going to be summer 20. It's going to be like that. So every year, they've got three major releases. Releases means updates. That's what it is. So it is increasing users' adoptability rate. And what is adoptability rate? Start using the Salesforce as well as staying onto the Salesforce. Staying onto the Salesforce. It goes both of them. Fulfilling, yeah. You got it? And it has got the highest user adoptability rate. So that's what we've got with Salesforce and CRM Basics. And we're done with this. Are you happy? Okay.